In this video, we introduce a simple device called the galvanometer, and we explore how the galvanometer can be used to construct an ammeter or a voltmeter. A galvanometer consists of a needle connected to an axle with coils of wire that rotate with the needle. In addition, there's a permanent magnet exerting a magnetic field across the coils. And in this picture, that magnetic field would point left to right. The needle points at a scale, which right now is pointing at zero. And a spring will return the needle back to zero after it's deflected. So when the galvanometer is plugged into a potential difference, current will flow through the coils, creating a magnetic field in the coils. Those coils then interact with the magnetic field from the permanent magnet. And the larger the current, the larger the torque exerted on the needle, and it will deflect further along the scale. So in our two examples, we're going to look at how do we use a galvanometer to make a voltmeter, and how do we use a galvanometer to make an ammeter. And in each case, the galvanometer has the same specs. So I'm just going to list them over here next to our galvanometer picture. First, we're told that the needle reaches full deflection when 0.0006 amps flows through the coils of the galvanometer. In other words, 0.6 milliamps. Second, we're told the galvanometer comes with internal resistance. That's the resistance of those coils of wire of 0.4 ohms. So let's take a look at how we could use this as a voltmeter. What we're told is that we want to design a voltmeter that's fully deflected when it's connected across a voltage of 10 volts. In other words, when we hook it in parallel across this potential difference of 10 volts, we get full deflection, that is a current of 0.0006 amps. May as well label the internal resistance here, that was 0.4 ohms. And so I can imagine if I just hook the galvanometer up to this 10 volt potential difference without adding some extra resistance to it, I would end up pulling a huge current. I would end up with I equals V over R, just using Ohm's law, 10 volts over 0.4 ohms internal resistance. And we'd end up pulling 25 amps of current through our galvanometer and the thing would burn up. So what we're going to do to prevent this and to control the maximum current is put a resistor in series with the galvanometer, such that when we connect to a 10 volt potential difference, we end up with 0.0006 amps of current running through it. Okay, so that 25 amps is a bad thing, and we're changing our strategy here. I'm going to apply Ohm's law to the galvanometer branch, V equals IR, and I know it has a 10 volt potential difference across it, and I'll plug in the numbers later. And I know I is 0.0006 amps when it's at maximum deflection, and my total resistance is big R, that's the resistor I'm going to put in series, and little r, the internal resistance of the galvanometer. Distributing the big I, I'm going to go ahead and solve everything symbolically here, and subtracting the I little r from both sides, I get that my big R required is V minus I little r divided by I. I get 10 minus 0.0006 times 0.4 ohms internal resistance over 0.0006. And I end up with 16,666 ohms, which I'm going to write as 16.7 kilo ohms. Again, what we've accomplished here is we made the resistance in the galvanometer branch just right so that if we hook it up in parallel over a 10 volt circuit element, we're going to pull a current of 0.0006 amps and get a maximum deflection of the needle. And then we could say when the needle is here, we're looking at 10 volts deflection. And this is how we can begin to calibrate this galvanometer to be a voltmeter. One final comment on voltmeter design is we want it to interfere very little with the actual circuit that we're trying to study. And so voltmeters have enormous resistances. We have 16.7 kilo ohms in there, which means we're barely drawing any current, right? It's 0.0006 amps. And so we're affecting the circuit that we're trying to study as little as possible when we connect this thing to it. In the second example, we want to use the same galvanometer as an ammeter. So ammeters need to be connected in series with the circuit so you can watch all the current flow through the ammeter and measure how much there is. And again, just using this generic box, I'm saying we have 2 amps flowing through this circuit, and I want my galvanometer to be fully deflected in this case. Well, if I simply put the galvanometer in series with the circuit, there'd be 2 amps of current going through it, minus a little bit because of this internal resistance, and the thing would burn up, right? It reaches maximum deflection at a fraction of a milliamp. So what I do is I put a resistor in parallel with the galvanometer branch, and that resistance should be very small so that the vast majority of current goes that way, and then I end up with 0.0006 amps going through the galvanometer branch when there's 2 amps flowing through the ammeter. So my total current is 2 amps, but just to stay symbolic for a second, I'm going to call this I total coming into the parallel combination. And that splits into I1 and I2. And I know what I1 is. That's 0.0006 amps. And I2, that would be 2 amps minus 0.0006 amps. And I'll write it down as an equation. I total equals I1 plus I2. And then I can say, because this is a parallel combination, the voltage drop over the galvanometer branch must be the same as the voltage drop over this new resistor that we're putting in. So I set these two things equal, and I'm going to use Ohm's law to quantify the voltage drop. This just V equals IR. So I have I1 little r, and that's got to be equal to the voltage drop across big R, which is going to be I2 big R. So I directly know I total and I1. So what I'm going to do is, in the first equation, I'm going to solve for I2 and then sub it into the second equation. And then we'll solve for big R. When I plug the numbers in, so I1, that was the name for the current in the galvanometer branch, which is 0.0006 amps. Internal resistance there was 0.4 ohms. And divide by I total, which was 2 amps, minus I1. When I run the numbers on this, I get 1.20 times 10 to the negative 4 ohms, which I could write as 0.12 milliohms. So just a final comment on our ammeter design. Ammeters always come with a very tiny resistance in parallel with the galvanometer branch, and this makes it so you have a minimum amount of interference with your circuit. I could say that because R is a very small thing, 0.12 milliohms, the potential difference across our ammeter is guaranteed to be really small. And again, our goal is to study the circuit without modifying it too much. So this is a good thing. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.